Hi, today we will install Windsurf on our Android phone, tablet or Chromebook. Right now I'm on Chromebook, so I will show you to install here. It is a Chromebook where we get Android features. So let's start it. First you need this Debian desktop. In my previous video I shown you to how to install it step by step. If you don't have, so go there and watch that video and set up it. Once you have this, you can continue with me. So open your Termux and login in Debian. Right now we are logged in with root, so Windsurf does not recommend us to run Windsurf as a root user, so we will create another user. So we need a package called sudo and add user and nano to edit the files. So install it. First I have already installed, so I will create an user by typing sudo add user test1. I am creating username test1 and give password, and then you done it, you can log in this. Right now I logged in test, I created it, but you can see when I'm running sudo apt update, so it is not working. After giving password, even I give password, it is not working because this user has not sudo privileges. So we will add it sudoers file and give the access of sudo to this user. To do this, use nano command nano slash etc slash sudoers and open this file. Scroll down and find this user privileges specifications and write your user here name, and this copy this all and paste it here. And now you need to save this file. To save this file, Control S and Control X for exit to this file. Now you can log in that. Recently I logged in test, which I don't add, so this is my by mistake I did, but I will log in another one, which is test one, which I gave the sudo permissions, sudo access. So I will enter in that user by su and test one, which is my username, and I will try to update the packages. By the way, our next command is sudo apt update and sudo apt upgrade. This will update every package and every repository here. By the way, I have already created a user which name is hello, so I will use that user. I created this user for show you to how you can create user if you don't have one. So I entered in hello. You know that Windsurf is not a regular package which we can install and run that. We need some another package to run that. So we will use this package one, sudo apt install gpg. And another one is apt transport https. This will allow to connection with https. You know that, you can understand by its name. Now I start with VNC server. Before this we will create a script. In my previous video I didn't show this. This script will help us to start our VNC server on localhost 1 always. If you start your VNC server and didn't stop that, so that will running in background, so this script will kill that first and start your VNC server on localhost 1, so you don't need to change your address always again and again. So create this script, you will find this on my blog post and you can copy from there and just create it. I written a blog post on this topic, so you can visit there for commands, links and for more information. To create this, use nano nano and whatever you want to give the name of your script. I will give it test.sh and just paste this script there and save it Control S and Control X. Once you have this, you can run it by dot slash. Before this, you need to make it executable by this chmod plus x and test.sh. Now you can run it dot slash test.sh. And now you can see this is cleaning and stopping previous VNC servers, and this will start on localhost 1. Now we will install the Windsurf file so we can execute that and run that. First run uname minus a command in your Termux to getting the architecture of your system, of your device. In my case, my device is 64-bit architecture and x86_64. It's mean my device is AMD64. So I will open this URL in my browser, so Windsurf file will be downloaded. And in other case, if your device is ARM64, so you need to come on this GitHub page and you need to download this tar.gz file. Once you have downloaded this file, you need to open it in Termux. Just open it in Termux and open directory. Now you will get this file in download section. You can see this file in downloads directory. Now open your VNC server and open a terminal. We will move that file to here so we can execute, or we can extract that file here and run that. First we need to go to the Termux home directory by cd /data/data/com.termux/files/home. You are in home directory right now, and by doing cd downloads you will go to in download section and you can see your file here. Now let's send this file or move this file in our downloads directory. Now we will extract it using tar-xvf, and our file name is windsurf and on. Remember, while extracting you should connect it to the internet, but right now my internet is not working, so I will use VPN and extract it again. First I will remove previous windsurf directory where all windsurf files are available. Now I connect it to my VPN and I will extract it, and now it will extract completely. Just go to the windsurf directory and /bin directory, and here you will see windsurf file which is executable. If you are directly trying to run it by /windsurf, it will not open because it does not support directly. We need to add --no-sandbox, so it will open. By the way, if you don't want this host first to install windsurf file, you can navigate to this website and you will find Debian commands to download step by step, copy 1x1 and paste in your terminal and run 1x1. You will see windsurf has been downloaded and you can run it by windsurf --no-sandbox. Just follow the getting started window. When you are login page, so we will first create our account on Codeium. So come on this website, codeium.com. For it you can use your regular browser like Chrome or any other browser. Open it and create an account here. Once you have done it, come back in VNC Viewer and just click on login and try manual way and click on copy link. This will copy the login URL. Just open it in your browser, in your same browser, and in some time if you have created an account, it will provide a auth token. Copy your auth token and come in VNC Viewer and paste it here and click on submit. Now windsurf will open, but here is an error of OS keyring and our login did not successful. If one time it's successful, but when you will close it, you will be logged out. You can also try to log in windsurf by clicking on login with Codeium. Cancel the process and provide your auth token, whatever you copied from the website. Once again you will get the OS keyring or gnome keyring error and login will not successful. So let's try to fix it. Just close this and back to your Termux with Debian and your username. We need to install gnome keyring. Just run this command sudo apt install gnome keyring and enter the password. This will install and unpacked. Once it's done, now let's restart our VNC Viewer. Just cancel it or close it and just start your VNC Viewer by /test.sh and open your VNC server in VNC Viewer. Once you are here, now open your windsurf again by going to windsurf directory, download and windsurf, and just run /windsurf --no-sandbox and wait for complete open the windsurf and you will be prompted to create password. Right now I'm prompting to enter my password because I have created already it. So I will enter my password. You will be prompted to create password and confirm that and open it. Once you have created a password and confirm that, just you will be logged in windsurf, or if you are not logged in, so you need to log in again with your auth token. Just click on login with Codeium and cancel the process and provide your auth token and hit enter. You will successfully log in windsurf. and now you will not be logged out when you will close the Windsurf. This will happen because we set up the gnome keyring and set it our password, and password should be rememberable, because if you forget your password, so this will be a big problem. And if you are, this is your personal device, so create a simple password like 123456, and don't think about hackers because they cannot hack Linux. So set your password rememberable and you can log in with that easily, and Windsurf will ready for you to code with AI. So let's do it. Before it, I want to say, you whenever you open any app like Chrome or Windsurf, you will be prompted for password. So give that password and unlock, and so everything will work fine. I have created this index and script file for my simple website, but here is a problem. When you will add products to cart, you cannot open cart, you cannot see what I added, and you cannot even check out. So I'm prompting to Cloud Sonnet to fix this error, and this will create a workflow, and it will take their time and fix this error and edit the files, and I will accept all. Once my file has been edited and saved, I will open it with my live server, and my live server is running on localhost 5500. So I will open it in my browser. Right now I am using Opera Mini. You can use your own browser like Chrome. I'm opening it and navigating to localhost colon 5500, and here is my website created by Cloud Sonnet with Windsurf. So those, this is all about Windsurf, how to install and fix login error and do coding with AI using Windsurf on our Android phone. If you are getting any error, any problem, so you can comment and I will definitely reply that. Thanks for watching this video and thanks for supporting me. Till then, stay tuned and stay focused.